This is a little bit more tricky. When you're photographing something light in colour, but you still want to get a low-key image. So this is something that we do in portraits a lot. I can't get models in my studio at the moment, although lockdown rules are changing, things are looking good. So it's coming, it will arrive. So instead, we're working with the amazing Polly, the polystyrene head on a stick. She is gonna be the model for this little bit. So I'm gonna photograph Polly against, you can just about see it over here. This is gonna be the background. This white wall here, okay? So that's gonna be the background for this shot. A white wall doesn't really tie in with low-key dark photography. Let's see how we get on. So again, I'm gonna put the camera just into program mode for flash. So it's just gonna be automatic flash. It's not gonna be anything clever. It's gonna be whatever the camera thinks is about right. And the end result, hold on, let me just switch over to workspace, there we go. Okay, so that's what we're getting. As you can see, that is correctly exposed. There's nothing wrong with that, except it's definitely not a low-key image. That is a perfectly average lighting. There we are, I now have backlighting. Let's angle it around something like that. And I'll take the same shot again. But this time, rather than letting the camera do everything, well, actually, let's see what happens. Let's just see what happens if I let the camera do everything. Here we go. Actually, it's not bad. why do I bother? Okay, yeah, the camera's done a pretty good job actually with that one. And that's because it is backlit. The background has gone dark. It's not quite black, it's gone dark. And the reason it's gone so dark is because of what dark actually is, what black actually is. Black is the absence of light. Okay, so on my little, you're down in the bottom. Black, look at that, okay, black. No light, okay, that's what black is. It's just the removal of light from the camera's point of view. So if we set the camera up so it can't actually see anything because it's underexposing the background goes black, that's it. Which, if you're outside doing a landscape or a wildlife shot, that's where the backlit sun exposed to the highlights comes in. I still think it was a tiny bit bright, so I'm gonna underexpose by a stop. And that's gonna give me really kind of dramatic, yeah, that looks a little bit better. Okay, and I can get even more edgy and moody. So all I'm gonna do is get Polly and move her yay far. That's probably even a little bit too far. Okay, something like that. So I've moved her about 2 feet. So I've made the light a bit further away than it was before and the angle a bit more acute. And I've got a load of flare, so let me just use the impromptu lens hood known as my hand, just to try and get a little bit more. Oh, a camera's still in auto mode. I'm also gonna take over at this point. Okay, let's just try that. Yeah, there we go. And that is me taking control of the exposure. But you can see how moving her further away means I get much more shadows. And shadows are all part of that low-key experience. Really deep shadows, that little bit of light just hitting the cheek and the eye. That is a low-key portrait, or at least it would be if she wasn't made of polystyrene. Okay.
So Francesca asks, could you use a speed light?
Yes, and she's got one. Absolutely, yes, you could. This is, I mean, I'm barely scraping the surface of what this flash can do. A speed light at half power would easily be able to keep up with this. So I've given Polly a set of sunglasses just to, well, A, make it look like it is actually a colour image and not a black and white image. And yeah, let's have a little look at the histogram. Let's have a little look at the histogram. Let's go find that image. And see what we get. Okay, and again, when we look at the image, you can see all of the histogram is over to the right-hand side, apart from there's a little tiny spike just there. Once again, a full range of tones through that image, more or less. So we are in the realms of low-key photography. That, for me, that ticks the right boxes. Everything's good. Yeah, happy with that as a low-key image. I don't really need to do anything more than that, other than have a real human being, which one day we will get another real human being in here. for sure.